Here I have question number 58, which states, if 2x minus 1 is a factor of this given polynomial and a into b is equal to 1, then the value of a minus 8b can be which of these options? So, coming to this given statement that 2x minus 1 is factor of this polynomial. So, if you equate 2x minus 1 to 0, you get x as 1 upon 2. Here, if it is a factor and you substitute x as 1 upon 2, the value of this will be equal to 0. That means, twice into, you get here 1 upon 2 cube plus a into 1 upon 2 square minus 5 into 1 upon 2 plus 2b. This will be equal to 0. This will be equal to 0 by factor theorem. This is by factor theorem. And when you simplify this further, you are going to get 1 upon 4 plus a upon 4 minus 5 by 2 plus 2b equal to 0. Let's simplify this one. On further simplification, it is going to result a plus 8b is equal to 9. So, on simplification, we have obtained that a plus 8b is equal to 9. Taking this case into consideration further, it is provided that a into b is equal to 1. If a into b is equal to 1, this implies b is equal to 1 upon a. So, I will be substituting here b as 1 upon a, and I will further simplify this equation. So, when you substitute here b as 1 upon a, you get a quadratic equation, that is a plus 8 upon a equal to 9, and when you take LCM, you get the equation as a square minus 9a plus 8 equal to 0. And when you solve this quadratic equation, you obtain possible values of a as 1 and 8. Considering that, you get corresponding values of b as 1 and 1 upon 8. Taking this into consideration further, we need to obtain the value of a minus 8b. When you substitute the first pair of value, you get it as minus 7, and for the second case, you get the value as plus 7. So, this will be possibly plus minus 7. The values of a minus 8b can be plus 7 or minus 7. Going back to the options, it states the value of a minus 8b can be 15, 9, 7 or 49. You can clearly find 7 here, which is present in option number 3. So, the correct answer for this question is option 3. So, we get here the required answer for this question. Let's proceed ahead to discuss our next question. Now, let's take up here question number 59. It states that the value of 0.32 whole cube minus 0.02 cube minus 0.3 cube is out of these four options. So, very first, if I can consider this in the form of a cube plus b cube plus c cube, you know that if a plus b plus c is equal to 0, then in that case, the value of a cube plus b cube plus c cube is equal to 3abc. So, if I consider a as 0.32, b as minus 0.02, c as minus 0.3, I clearly get a value equal to 0. That means this given expression has the value, that is a cube plus b cube plus c cube is equal to 3abc. It will definitely have the value equal to 3 times 0.32 into 0.02 into 0.3. When you get the product, here the product is equal to 0.00576. So, this is the required answer for this question. Out of these four options, I can clearly say the correct answer is given by option number 4. You can definitely mark here the answer for this question as option 4. I hope this question is clear. Let's take up our next question. This is question number 60. It states that in the given figure, if PR is parallel to UV, then 1/5 of supplement of angle TSR equals which of these four options? So, here we are talking about this PR which is parallel to UV. Now, in this case, you can observe this angle PQU. Here, this is a linear pair angle with this angle UQR. You need to obtain this angle TSR. let me consider this as x. While here, with the property of linear pair angles, this becomes 110 degrees and this angle will be the reflex of angle measuring 95 degrees and you will obtain this one as 265 degrees. You observe this pentagon UTSRQ, sum of 5 angles of the pentagon is measuring 540 degrees. With that, I can easily obtain x. So, I have here 30 degrees plus 110 degrees plus x plus 65 degrees plus 265 degrees. These 5 angles have the sum equal to 540 degrees. When you simplify this, you get the value of x equal to 70 degrees. X is obtained, but here I need 1/5 of supplement of x. So, basically you need 1/5 of supplement of x, which is obtained as 180 degree minus x. So, 180 degree minus 70 gives me 1/5 of 110 degrees, which is equal to 22 degrees. So, the required answer for this question is 22 degrees, which gives me 1/5 of supplement of angle TSR. You can clearly find that in option number 2. So, the answer for this question is option 2. I hope this question is clear to you. Now, let's take up our next question.